Dear High Level Representative of COP23, distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to announce that 10 days ago the Republic of Macedonia ratified the Paris Agreement. As a new reform government, within 3 months, we have used the spirit of this COP23, further, faster, together, as a tool to provide everything that is necessary to ratify the Paris Agreement, with no votes against. Republic of Macedonia reinforces the commitment of joining the global efforts to address the climate change and to ensure low carbon growth and development. Even more, in the second biennial update report, which will be officially submitted to UNFCCC by the end of the year, we have analyzed possible increase of our climate actions, whether we want to continue along the safe way or be more ambitious climate runner. Although the Republic of Macedonia is not an Annex I country to the UNFCCC, it is as well a candidate country for EU membership and thus must adhere to the EU climate and energy policy, which actually covers the commitments of Annex I countries. Having this in mind, the Republic of Macedonia has made voluntary efforts to incorporate UNFCCC reporting principles that apply to Annex I parties to the greatest extent possible. We are committed to climate action, but we must find a mechanism for additional financial support in order to implement the activities planned in our climate change strategic documents. As a small country situated in the Balkan region with middle income, we lack access to more resources. The middle income countries, besides from the state budget, loans from the international financial institutions, are still in need of grants in order to address the most urgent mitigation and adaptation needs. This should be taken into consideration, particularly by the Green Climate Fund. Without implementation, the ratification will stay just an ordinary vote. The challenge that is ahead of us requires that we organize ourselves in order to provide more focused response in line with our obligations and take crucial further steps towards transformative change. The Ministry of Environment and Physical Planning and the government of the Republic of Macedonia are strongly dedicated to move our country from safe way to climate runner, and we know how to get there. Skopje, our capital city, is one of the most polluted cities in the world. There is a strong link between the air pollution and the climate change. Within the second biennial update, we have made one step forward towards becoming climate champions by analyzing 3 win-win measures related to the heating in the capital of Macedonia and their impact on reduction of the both GHG emissions and local air pollution in Skopje. Climate change gives an opportunity for the country and for to grow and develop. We are ready to use the opportunity faster and together for further generation. Thank you.